back to the ongoing report with the rescue ready called public service team. According to reports, the Dubuque Fire Department has been experiencing a record low in staffing shortages for months now. This has been due to retirement, resignations, and the struggle to find new recruiting personnel. I interviewed the Dubuque Fire Chief and Lieutenant T at the inside level.
Every year we see fewer and fewer candidates that want to come into fire service. I think it's across the board though, when you look at multiple professions, nursing and teaching, police officers, there's a downward trend in all those areas. So it's problematic. And I know that the International Fire Chiefs Association, the International Association of Firefighters, and all the other groups that are in our profession are trying to rectify that, you know, correct that. When I started, a misconception that I had was that I had to look like the traditional firefighter, and they were 6 foot tall, mustache, they were male. I think that's the biggest one. I think that individuals who have an interest in doing what firefighters do, it's a physical job. We do a lot with paramedicine. You know, we do EMS and fire. There's technical rescue. If you have an interest in that and you just don't think, you know, hey, I'm not strong enough, tall enough, you know, I would encourage people to reach out and talk to a firefighter, because we really appreciate and value diversity in our field. And we struggle with that a little bit, getting some people that are different and unique and have a different approach. So yeah, I would say find a mentor and partner with a firefighter, and they'll help to get you some, you know, get you some opportunities that you might be able to test it and see if it's for you. It's been a blessing for me to find this profession. I think that serving others, being a public servant, is one of the best things. It's very, very rewarding. There's not a day that's the same. We're very physically active. We're out in the community. You know, we teach people. And then we, you know, we get to respond to our community members when they need our help. And so there's something very fulfilling about doing that, providing our service and helping our community when they need, you know, need help.
It's a whole nother family. So when we're here for 24 hours, we have each other's back. If we need our roof shingled on our off days, we send an email out and, hey, I'm doing a roofing project. People come out of the woodworks. We help each other out. It's no different than when we're on a call, we're on a fire. We all have each other's backs. We're there for each other. It's a great family, and it's another family besides my own at home. So the camaraderie is probably one of the best things about the fire service, and how we have each other's backs. So all the way through the ranks.
Rescue ready for the public service team. I'm Emily.